Israelites, I have some great news for all of you. You have to listen to this. We now have a new baptism, a new way of getting repentance. Forget the idols, forget the sacrifices, forget all that. Now we have this baptism of John. We can get our sins forgiven. Forget the sacrifice. This is a new way. This is a new age. John has shown us a new way. The baptism. The baptism of water that can forgive all shows us a new way to do this. And next week, okay, I heard and I know that a guy named Paul is coming and he has been spreading the good word. So please, just like you listen to me, please listen to him. He has a good message to share with you.
So I know Apollos came to you guys last week, and I wanted to just follow up on a couple of things that he had said and see if you guys have any questions. So, did you guys learn about the Spirit, or have you heard anything about the Holy Spirit?
I don't think they heard about it.
Okay, well then let's talk about the Holy Spirit and about Jesus Christ who came after John, and who not only provided us with the baptism of repentance, but gave us love and gave us this Holy Spirit, which can guide us and can help us through the way. And now we as the people of God have this connection with Him, and He's opened the door for us through His resurrection and through the salvation that He gave us.
Paul, called to be an apostle of Jesus Christ through the will of God, and Sosthenes, our brother, to the church of God which are at Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints with all who in every place call on the name of Jesus Christ our Lord, both theirs and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Paul, a bondservant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, separated to the gospel of God which he promised before through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, concerning his Son Jesus Christ our Lord, who was born of the seed of David according to the flesh, and declared to be the Son of God with power according to the Spirit of holiness by the resurrection from the dead, to all who are in Rome, beloved of God, called to be saints.
I love preaching to everybody, but I think the people in Jerusalem and Rome really like to hear what the Holy Spirit has to say and the message that Jesus gave. So, but I really just want to fast and pray about it, and if you could pray for me too, I think that'd be really great.
Down with Jesus! Down with Paul! Get them out of our city! This is our city! This is not their city! This is Diana's city!
Why are you so against Paul? What did he do to you?
Are you kidding? You know Ephesus is Diana's city. What are these people doing talking about some god named Jesus or something? He already died.
Well,
forget this guy.
Well, everybody knows that the city is for Ephesus, so maybe you should just take it up with the lawyers and the governors instead of acting so rash.
I will, but I have to tell everybody, down with Jesus, down with Paul. This is Diana's city.
I really just want to encourage the people. They need to know that we have to redeem our time, and God has given us such precious time, and we need to season our words with salt and make every minute count. You know, God didn't give us this life for no reason. We have such short time that we really need to make it the best and make it for God and do everything for God.
So where are you going to go now?
I think I'll go to Greece. I think that's where the Spirit's calling me right now, and I think it'll be nice to go to Greece for the time being. I think that's where I'm going to go. So there's the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. There's three, but they're one. I know it's a complicated theology, but you really have to understand that this is the principle. You know, there is a beginning to the end. They're from the beginning to the end. So Jesus, when He came, He was there from the beginning. He wasn't just incarnate now. And then the Holy Spirit, that's what works within us. That's what gives us all our power, and that's what gives us everything we have. You know, that's what really moves us and allows it.
Oh my God, Eutychus! Oh my God!
Eutychus! Oh no! Is he alright?
It's okay, he's still alive. He's still alive. Just come on, get up.
Oh my God, it's a miracle! Oh,
thank God.
It's a miracle, oh my God!
Praise
the Lord, praise the Lord!
Just get him some water. Go get him some water.
Oh my God, is he okay? Wow. Wow.
You know from the first day that I came to Asia, in what manner I always lived among you, serving the Lord with all humility, with many tears and trials which happened to me by the plotting of the Jews, how I kept back nothing that was helpful, but proclaimed it to you and taught you publicly from house to house,
testifying to Jews and also to Greeks, repentance towards God and faith toward our Lord Jesus Christ. And see, now I go bound in the Spirit to Jerusalem, not knowing the things that will happen to me there, except that the Holy Spirit testifies in every city, saying that chains and tribulations await me. But none of these things move me, nor do I count my life dear to myself, so that I may finish my race with joy, and the ministry which I receive from the Lord Jesus, to the gospel of the grace of God. And indeed now I know that you all, among whom I have gone preaching the kingdom of God, will see my face no more. Therefore I testify to you this day that I am innocent of the blood of all men, for I have not shunned to declare to you the whole counsel of God. Therefore take heed to yourselves and to all the flock among which the Holy Spirit has made you overseers, to shepherd the church of God, which he purchased with his own blood. For I know this, that after my departure, savage wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock.
Don't go! You can't go!
You can't go!
Dude, they're gonna tie you up and bind you there!
It's okay, they can tie me up and they can kill me, but I'm ready to die for the name of the Lord Jesus.
That was so creepy.
I was like,
you were just staring at
the. I know.
We can't see your face. It's just your chest.
What if he's just, what if he's sitting down and he's
you can't see his face. It just like it just starts off at you. Eutychus, like, Eutychus, and then he's gonna shift to you. Okay, you ready?
Ready. I'm gonna sit like this.
Okay, and then fix yourself. Quick.
Okay, then let me zoom out just a little. Okay, actually, okay. You guys ready? Mm-hmm.